Hey y'all, what's up? My name is Sonali. Welcome to a new video. Today I'm filming a Princess Polly haul and I'm so excited because it could not be more perfect timing. I'm headed to the beach in 2 days and I got so many cute things for my beach trip. I'm gonna be there for like 2 weeks. I think it's supposed to be in the 80s, which is weird because it's literally like colder than where I am now in Austin, but I got such cute pieces and I also couldn't help myself. I got some more fall items too for when I get back. Shout out to Princess Polly for sponsoring this video. They actually ship from within the US and you qualify for free express shipping if your order is over $50. Princess Polly also offers Afterpay and Shop Pay for all US customers. I'm gonna link everything mentioned in the video below and you guys already know I'm gonna hook you up with a discount code. Use the code on the screen, Sonali20, to get you 20% off, and let's get into the video. The first top we have is the Darlington crop top in the color beige. Usually I would get a size 10 in pretty much everything Princess Polly, but now I feel like at least in the top I can go for an 8. So it fits perfectly. It actually reminds me of, I want to say it's the Kayla top. It's the green top I've been wearing for like a lot of events. It's just so flattering. So when I saw this, I was like, okay, I need another one in like a different color. The style between this one and the other one is very similar, but this one cuts a little bit higher. The other one is lower, so you definitely have to be conscious of what bra you would wear. I have another crop top. This one is called the Rib Buster. I got it in the color white because I wanted something basic that I could wear with pretty much everything. And also, I live in Austin, Texas, so it's not gonna get cold for a while, which sucks. So that means I'll still be wearing pretty summery clothes or at least just like crop tops with like longer jeans. I cannot wait to wear my mom jeans again. Oh my goodness, it makes me so excited even thinking about that. I feel like I would definitely use this as a layering piece or honestly just like going out on the town like this. Really don't have to dress up too much here in Austin, thankfully, to go out. So I feel like this would be like a perfect going out outfit if I didn't want to layer anything on top. Speaking of layering, I got this jacket and I've had other like shirt jackets, I guess, but not like the OG style, like this cute little plaid style. So I finally got one. I can add it to my wardrobe now. I feel like I'm going to be living in this. I feel like if I wore like a basic outfit and just threw this on, I would like look so much more put together, but also like effortlessly put together, if that makes sense. I did size up in this one. I got a size 12 and it's pretty long on me. So I definitely could have stuck to the size 10 if I wanted it to be just like, you know, normally oversized, but I think I kind of like it oversized. It gives me all the comfy fall vibes. I feel like the closest thing I'm gonna get to fall weather is going to the beach soon because it's gonna be a little bit chillier there, but still kind of like hot. Next up, we have a Cindy cropped sweater. I've always wanted one of these kind of like sweater vests. I mean, I guess this isn't really a vest. I was thinking you could like layer it with something. I've seen like people layer it with like button down kind of things, and I actually got a button down dress, so I kind of want to see what it looks like over this. But you could definitely wear it as a normal just like top. You don't have to like layer it. Also, if you guys have never shopped at Princess Polly, the quality on everything is honestly 10 out of 10. This sweater specifically is like the perfect amount of thickness, not too crazy thick, not too thin. It's like just perfect. Also, I'm sorry about the lighting. It was a gloomy day, but now the sun's coming out, which we love, so I'm really not complaining about being hit with this light. Also, can we take a minute for this filming background? Because I'm pretty sure this is my first video with the couch and the cactus. I feel like I talk about these two things in every video, but I just love them so much. And I still need to get artwork for the back, so gonna work on that. Next up is a graphic tee, and this one actually says Yosemite. Can you see it? There we go. I got it in a size 10. I kind of wanted to size up just so I could like wear it to sleep, which obviously I still could. I just need to wear shorts underneath it. I seriously cannot have enough graphic tees because they're perfect for running errands. You can like dress them up. You can have it like look like street style with biker shorts and cool sneakers. So you can really do a lot with these shirts. So that's why I definitely want to stock up on them. And I don't know if you can see the color really well on camera because it's a little bit muted, but it is this like beige kind of yellow color. Next up is the Saatchi sweater in beige, and I love this pattern. It's kind of like, what's it called? Houndstooth pattern, I think. I like it because usually I don't really get patterned stuff. I always try to stick to like solids or neutrals, but since this is a neutral, I was like, okay, I feel like that's good enough. Like, we could do a pattern. So I'm trying to experiment a little bit with my fall wardrobe, but this is also kind of like a longer sweater if you wanted to just like wear it as a kind of like a shirt dress with some leggings. I feel like you could get away with that. I did get the size large slash extra large in this one. Also, I love that the sleeves are kind of like that looser fit because sometimes sweaters just make me feel really constricted. Last fall and winter, I lived in like two sweaters and then just like all my just sweatshirts. So I feel like it's really important just to have like a couple like really good quality sweaters. Next up, we have some fun fall pants, and these are honestly so flattering. They hit me perfectly where I want them at my torso, and I just paired it with this for now, this like corset top kind of thing, and I think it's so cute. This would be so adorable at like a pumpkin patch. I could see it now. On the bottom, they're kind of like a flare or like a boot cut. I feel like I would say more of a flare, and honestly, if they had the like skinny slim fit at the bottom, I feel like I wouldn't like them as much. I went a little crazy and I got like a bunch of white dresses. I don't know why, but they're just like so pretty. So first off, we are starting with the Alena mini dress, and I did get this in a size 10. It fits perfectly, and you know, this whole situation is a lot better. I feel like the old gals could never. I guess you could kind of wear it as like an off the shoulder, but I feel like off the shoulder is just kind of like overdone now. I feel like if I had the choice, I wouldn't do that. I think it looks so pretty and like dainty, and I'm definitely gonna bring this to the beach, maybe wear it for a date night. But knowing me, I'll probably like spill something on it. So definitely gonna have to wear a napkin bib with this. Up next, we have the Fiorella mini dress. And I also got this in a size 10. This one has like this tie back. I don't think I tied it very well just cause I was like trying it on. In my last Princess Polly haul, I got like a similar dress, but it had these pom-pom rows all the way down the dress. It's so cute. So I kind of wanted to get something similar. I got that one in a pink, so had to get another white dress. Up next, we have the cherry mini dress in the color green. It definitely needs some steaming, so don't mind the wrinkles, but I feel like this is such a flattering dress. It's not a silk dress, which online I definitely thought it was going to be, but I'm kind of happy it's not because I feel like silk dresses don't always flatter the body, but this is kind of like more of a linen-y fabric, which I definitely prefer. Also, just a heads up, it is a mini dress, so it is on the shorter side. I'd probably wear some like Spanx kind of things with this. Guys, I told you I got way too many white dresses, but this one is the Aisha long sleeve collared dress kind of thing, and this one's more flowy. I have another button down that I'm gonna show you guys next, and that one's a little bit more form-fitting. I wanted to try out both just to see how I could style both differently, because I feel like that's more of a corset vibe, whereas I compare this dress with a sweater vest or even a sweater and have these like little collars pop out, but we need some cold weather for that first, so gotta wait for that. But this dress is so flattering. In the next few months, I actually have a work conference coming up, and I was a little worried because I obviously work from home and I do not have any like work clothes. So I feel like this could definitely be an option for that. Last white dress, I swear I wanted to go out with a bang. This is called the CoverGirl mini dress. I got this in a size 10, and look how like beautiful it is. It's so structured. The quality is like so good. The sides have these pleats on them, and even the sleeves are so detailed. They are kind of long on me. I maybe wouldn't go out to like eat in this, but it is such a beautiful piece. This is the last clothing piece I picked out. I have some accessories that I'm so excited to show you guys. Anyways, this is the Holo set in blue, and it is so cute. It's so thick, very like warm, and I had like a tough time kind of like pulling this over just because it's not super stretchy since it is thick. But then I realized that there was a zipper on the side. I was like, that makes a lot of sense. So I went through all this struggle. That zipper is going to be very helpful. But I feel like this is just so freaking cute. Like, just imagine me running errands on South Congress or even going to the mall or something in this cute set with like really cool sneakers. Maybe even throw on a ball cap. I'm like really into hats right now. But yeah, this is the Harlow set. And also come to the beach with me. Speaking of the beach, I saw this on princesspolly.com and I had to get it. It's kind of like this like terry material, and it's just like this peach orange bag, and I thought it'd be a cute little beach bag. I feel like Toast came out of nowhere, but honestly I'm so here for it because it just looks so effortless. The name of this bag is Somersault Terry Tote Peach. The last thing I have to show you are my new favorite sneakers. These are literally, first of all, so comfortable. I was telling Ryan, I was like, wait, you're telling me I've been missing out on New Balances this whole freaking time? I slipped them on and like, I swear I don't even need to break them in. And I feel like every shoe you kind of need to break in, but these are like walking on a cloud. But also this color is the color Sea Salt. I think the style is like 4 or 5 7 or something, but this color, the pink kind of nude thing, is called Sea Salt. And I literally looked everywhere and I'm pretty sure all of the sizes are sold out like everywhere. And I got these on Princess Polly like literally last week and they're all sold out. So I'm really hoping that they bring them back. I want you guys all to have them and we can all match because I just freaking love these shoes. So that is it on my Princess Polly haul. I hope you guys enjoyed it. All of the links are down below. Don't forget to use my discount code Sonali20 and that will give you 20% off. It was the first haul that I filmed after my surgery. So it was so exciting trying on just like different sizes, even just seeing how I fit better into the clothes. It just makes me so happy. So I'll definitely be updating you guys on, you know, post-op later down the road. So subscribe down below. And if you guys don't already know what I'm talking about, you can search on my YouTube channel and you'll definitely find it in some of my most recent vlogs. Also, if you guys are interested in seeing day-to-day content, then go over to my Instagram. You can follow me over there. It's so_gnarly without the G. And I will see y'all in my next video. Bye.